I've been, I'm first of all deeply honored to have been called to speak before all of you all. Thank you so much, Madhu sir, for that. And I've been asked to speak about my journey in music. Music has been everything for me since birth. My mother is my guru, so that goes without saying. But even then, because I'm only 22 years old, this account is really brief. So, to tell you what music is for me, it begins with my mother. So music is, for me, music is Amma. Because music, whatever approach to music, whatever idea of music, whatever understanding of music that I have, whatever passion I have towards it, whatever I have ever come to understand about music, it has always been through and because of Amma. So my mother is my guru, and she is everything for me when it comes to music. And I started learning when I was 2 years old. So that is the official age when I sat down for a class. So till then, I was exposed to classes. I was in and around classes which Amma was taking, but I never took the interest because I was less than two. And classes and music at that particular point of time was always it's something that's always happening at home. It was not something that I had to look forward to, or that I specifically took an interest in till much later on. Classes at home used to be a very routine thing. It used to always be music classes used to be a routine thing at home. It used to be a very normal daily activity. I couldn't even imagine life out of that. I used to ask my friends how they manage the silence at home, because I have become so geared to studying with music, studying with songs, and studying with Sarli Varsai, Janta Varsai, and Geetams in the background. So I cannot even study right now without any such background music. And I did my schooling till my third standard in Muscat. I don't remember those days because it was really long time back, and musically I was not doing anything except learning from Amma. I used to sing here and there in small family get-togethers because I was a really small child. I didn't take up the interest, nor did I have any real idea or goal about music. And then for a brief 1.5 years, Amma and I had come down to India while Dad was pursuing another job in Bahrain. And then we moved to Bahrain. So I did my schooling from 5th to 12th in Bahrain before moving down to Chennai. And that was the period that demarcated for me, that defined for me the interest in music. I was part of Amma's advanced level of students till my 8th standard. And what happened when I was in my 8th standard is everybody else were in their 12th and in their 11th. So the whole group and the whole batch disbanded because they had to leave for their studies and pursue their academics. So I was suddenly left all to myself. There was no batch in place for me to go and continue sitting. So I lost my interest in music. I was into football completely, and I used to play football all the time. And I have troubled Amma a lot in that aspect, because she used to force me to sing, and she used to force me to practice for all the culturals and all the competitions at the school level. But I used to be busy with football. I used to be crazy about that game, and I used to waste all my energy and time behind it. And my father used to break it to me that I am no good in football. He used to remind me about that every day, and he used to tell me that you can't make it, you are not good enough. But I think that only fueled my interest in football. And for a couple of years, I had completely left music, almost. I had given up singing. I wasn't interested, I wasn't taking it up seriously. It was too normal a thing for me to pursue because of Amma's classes, and I regret that now, because if I had utilized that much time more in my practice, and I would have brought myself forward a little more. So what happened when I was in my 9th standard and my 10th standard is we had come down for my vacations, summer vacations, and Amma decided that I needed some external spark. I needed some push from outside, and so she took me to singer Unnikrishnan and to music director Sharath, and basically just for them to audition me, not in pursuit of any chance, but just to get an opinion, just to get advice, just to get some direction. So these are people that I've always looked up to. I've always looked up to them because of their popularity, because of their skill. And when they told me that you are talented, you have the serious skill, the serious potential to make it to do something with your talent, to go out there and to sing, to make it as a really seriously good singer who can look take playback singing as a career, performing as a career. That gave me a lot of push. That made me suddenly stop and think whether I was spending the right amount of time on my talents. And it was then, it was in my 10th standard that I decided to take a 180 degrees turn, drop things I'm not good at like football and focus on music. And under Amma's guidance, I spent a lot of time on music. I used to put in a good amount of practice, and with God's grace, all of that has paid off. After schooling, when I came down here, college was a new environment. College was a different thing altogether. Growing up in the Gulf, growing up in Muscat and Bahrain was, it geared me up in a different way. It groomed me in a different way. I was, to be truthful and to be frank, I was not ready for the competition here. I couldn't suddenly step up to what was expected of me in terms of singing. I came in all ready to take the place by storm, only to realize that people are already doing it for years. So, and all the days that I was playing football, everybody else was singing over here. So it was difficult to gear up to the challenge, to rise up to the occasion, but I had Amma with me, and she groomed me in all the ways possible. She trained me in all the ways possible. And in my second year of college, 2013 December, the first auditions of JITV, Jaya Super Singer South India, happened. That was a very big stage for me, because I was somebody who had not grown up in India. I was not used to this. I was not used to any sort of preliminary practice or popularity that was needed as a prerequisite for such shows. I had just jumped into it without thinking whether I would be able to rise up to the occasion. But with God's grace, I did. And that show panned out for a very long time. It went up to 2 years, the whole shooting and the telecast and everything put together. It gave me a lot of experience, and if at all there has been a boost in my confidence, if at all there has been anything that has groomed my singing in a very much more commercial and professional way, it has been Jaya Super Singer, because I received valuable inputs from people like SP Shailaja ma'am, Nitishri ma'am, Bharadwaj sir. The judges groomed us, the judges gave us tips, improved us on a completely holistic level, and I managed to clinch the title with God's grace last year in July. And that was a redeeming moment for me, because it was not only my hard work, it was Amma's hard work, it was Amma's dreams and Amma's work that manifested into that victory. And that was a very nice moment, because it was a reward for all the work that had been put in by Amma and by me for not just these 2 years, but for years and years before that. All of Amma's aspirations and everything culminated to that. And after winning the title, it has been a good 1 year. There are shows that are coming my way. A couple of my friends, Tanuj and Praveen, who have also participated in reality shows. One of them participated in the same reality show. We have started a group called Musicos, and it's doing well. We've started doing corporate shows. We've started doing all sorts of stage shows as per the requirements of the clients. And well, here I am. Thank you so much for inviting me. I think I'll move on to something that I can do better, like singing.
It's because of JITV Amma or Amma?
For me, there is only one Amma.
I have to
sing your songs as per Madhusa's request. I'll sing a couple of songs. Should I use this mic or should I
use
this?
There's one
more here. Mic there, whichever you are comfortable.
Oh, நீங்க வந்து அது கேட்டு ஓட் போடலாம் நினைச்சல அம்மாக்கு
கண்டிப்பா போட வேண்டியது.
Hello. Yep. Check. Okay.
Switch this off.
Okay. Hello. Check. Okay. I think that's a better mic. I think I just.
It's a better mic.
I'll sing a couple of songs that I used to always sing for the culturals and competitions in school. We were all restricted to Hindi
Since
songs.
Since your reference was so much, you sing that Rajinikanth song of Amma.
But which was the final song that, for which you were awarded the...
ஒரு நாள் போதுமா?
चाहूंगा मैं तुझे सांझ सवेरे, फिर भी कभी अब नाम को तेरे आवाज मैं ना दूंगा, आवाज मैं ना दूंगा। चाहूंगा मैं तुझे सांझ सवेरे, फिर भी कभी अब नाम को तेरे आवाज मैं ना दूंगा, आवाज मैं ना दूंगा। चाहूंगा मैं तुझे सांझ सवेरे, देख मुझे सब है पता, सुनता है तू मन की सदा। देख मुझे सब है पता, सुनता है तू मन की सदा। मितवा मेरे यार भी तुझको बार बार आवाज मैं ना दूंगा, आवाज मैं ना दूंगा। चाहूंगा मैं तुझे सांझ सवेरे।
What else would you like me to sing? I don't know a lot of songs.
பததபா ma ma pa pa ma ga ga ma ma ga ri ri ga ga ri sa ga ga ri sa ni da pa pa ka yaalin rum pa pa ma pa da da 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 pa pa ma pa da ma pa ma da pa da ma pa ga ma ga pa ma pa ga ma ri ga ri ma ga ma ri ga da ri ni da da sa ri ni da da சரி நிசாசால் குழல் என்றும் யாழ் என்றும் சிலர் கூறுவார் என் குரல் கேட்ட பின்னாலே அவர் மாறுவார் குழல் என்றும் யாழ் என்றும் சிலர் கூறுவார் என் குரல் கேட்ட பின்னாலே அவர் மாறுவார் அழியாத கலை என்று என்னை பாடுவார் என அறியாமல் எதிர்ப்போர்கள் எழுந்தோடுவார் என அறியாமல் எதிர்ப்போர்கள் எழுந்தோடுவார் இசை கேட்க எழுந்தோடி வருவார் என்றோ எழுந்தோடி வருவார் என்றோ எழுந்தோடி தோடி இசை கேட்க எழுந்தோடி வருவார் என்றோ எனக்கு இணையாக தர்பாரில் எவரும் உண்டோ தர்பாரில் எவரும் உண்டோ தர்பாரில் எனக்கு இணையாக தர்பாரில் எவரும் உண்டோ கலையாத மோகன சுவை நான் என்றோ மோகன சுவை நான் என்றோ மோகனம் கலையாத மோகன சுவை நான் என்றோ கானடா அவள் பாட்டு தேனடா இசை தெய்வம் வாணியடா
Thank you so much, sir.
Do you know Hari Om from Bejubara?
Tamil Pata?
Tamil Pata.
I am not sure if you would have been. Chitra and Vedgari.
Okay, I'll sing that.
Pata Pata.
சித்திரம் பேசுதடி உன் சித்திரம் பேசுதடி என் சிந்தை மயங்குதடி சித்திரம் பேசுதடி முத்துச்சரங்களை போ முத்துச்சரங்களை போல் மோகன புன்னகை நின்னதடி முத்துச்சரங்களை போல் மோகன புன்னகை நின்னதடி சித்திரம் பேசுதடி தாவும் கொடி மேலே சித்திரம் பேசுதடி என் மனம் நீ அறிவாய் உந்தன் எண்ணங்கள் நான் அறிவேன் என் மனம் நீ அறிவாய், முந்தன் எண்ணமும் நான் அறிவேன், இன்னமுமையை போல் மௌனம் ஏனடித்தே மொழியே, இன்னமுமையை போல் மௌனம் ஏனடித்தே மொழியே, சித்திரம் பேசுதடி என் சிந்தை மயங்குதடி, சித்திரம் பேசுதடி. Thank you.
Why not a duet song with your mom?
Cordially told me you're talking.
Actually, I'm building up my repertoire of songs. I still have to learn a lot of songs. I learned a lot of songs for the competition, but still not enough.
Sing a nice Malayalam song.
Okay.
Shamamekhame Niyan Prema தூதுமாய் தூரே போய் வரு, ஷாமமேகமே நீ என் பிரேம தூதுமாய் தூரே போய் வரு, எந்தே தேவி கேளும் தூர மந்திரத்தில் போய் வரு, ஷாமமேகமே நீ என் பிரேம தூதுமாய் தூரே போய் வரு, காமரூப காணும் நீ என் காதரையா காமினியே, கண்ணு நீரின் புன்சிரியாய் காற்றுலைக்கும் தீபமாய், விஸ்ரதமாம் தந்திரிகளில் விஸ்ரதமாம் தந்திரிகளில் விஸ்மிருதமாம் நாதமாய், என்றே தேவி கே மந்திரத்தில் போவரு, ஷாமமேகமே நீ என் பிரேம தூதுமாய் தூரே போய் வரு.
That's a Salil Chaudhary composition. What is that?
Salil Chaudhary.
That's a Salil Chaudhary composition.
He composed it, my man.
So do you have orchestra group or like your...
Pardon me, sir?
We have orchestra group when you perform...
It's not an orchestra group, it's a karaoke. We use karaoke.
We didn't get the song which you like best.
So I like best. The song is about music and also about a singer talking about his singing. So it's a very beautiful song, it's very close to me.
Vanamalai pole pudu paadalgal gaanamalai tu முகிலாடல்கள், நீலைக்கும் கானமிது நெடுநாள் வாழும் இது, வானமழை போலே புது பாடல்கள் கானமழை தூவும் முகிலாடல்கள், இதயம் ராத்திரியில் இஸ் இசையால் அமைதி பெறும் இருக்கும் காயமெல்லாம் இசையால் அறிவிடும் கொதிக்கும் பாறையிலும் இசையால் பூமலரும் இரும்பு பாறையிலும் இசையால் நீர் கசியும் பழிவாங்கும் பகை நெஞ்சும் இசையால் சாந்தி பெறும் வானமழை போலே பொது பாடல்கள் கானமழை தூவும் முகிலாடல்கள் நிலைக்கும் கானமீது நெடுநாள் வாழும் இது வானமழை போலே புது பாடல்கள் கானமழை தூவும் முகிலாடல்கள்
காதலி. Okay. Your mother's favorite song, I suppose.
It's been a very long time since I sang this song. Sang it for the competition in the beginning stages.
எனக்கொரு காதலி இருக்கின்றாள் அவள் ஏழு ஸ்வரங்களில் சிரிக்கின்றாள் எனக்கொரு காதலி இருக்கின்றாள் அவள் ஏழு ஸ்வரங்களில் சிரிக்கின்றாள் கீதம் அவளது வளையோசை கீதம் அவளது வளையோசை நாதம் அவளது தமிழோசை தமிழோசை எனக்கொரு காதலி இருக்கின்றாள் அவள் ஏழு ஸ்வரங்களில் சிரிக்கின்றாள் பஞ்சமம் பேசும் பார்வை இரண்டும் பஞ்சமம் பேசும் பார்வை இரண்டும் பஞ்சனை போடும் எனக்காக தெய்வதம் என்னும் திருமகள் மேனி கைகளை அணைக்கும் இனிதாக இனிதாக எனக்கொரு காதலி இருக்கின்றாள் அவள் ஏழு ஸ்வரங்களில் சிரிக்கின்றாள்.
Thank you.
Who's your favorite Tamil singer, TMS?
No, my favorite Tamil singer, I have many. Depending on the era. If it was, actually my role model is Yeshudas. He's